of the day, hey. And you don't have to hide away, yeah. You'll be my boy. But for now, it's time to run, it's time.
Good morning! Now, I'm a traveler. I love exploring to the most beautiful places on Earth. And when Apple released the Ultra, I was amazed.
So I sat down with a professional diver and a professional triathlete to discuss all Apple Watch Ultra, and we pushed the Apple Watch Ultra to its limits.
Our conclusions at the end. The Apple Watch Ultra is Apple Watch at its maximum potential, a device that honestly has no limits. This is the Apple Watch Ultra, and this is my review.
I am Maria Barbena, I'm 29 years old. I'm from Barcelona.
I'm a sea lover since I was a child, so that's why I'm a diving instructor.
I'm always in the water in the summer and even in the winter. I travel to tropical countries and I do my dives there. I think that the Apple Watch has never been taken seriously by runners or divers like me because it lacks battery and all the stats that I have here in a normal diving computer.
I mean, what Maria said is so true. The Apple Watch lacked a lot of features that the pros needed. I mean, there was a lot that needed to be changed, starting off with the design.
Apple Watch Ultra features a totally new and rugged redesigned titanium casing. It's 49 millimeters, making it the biggest Apple Watch yet. Now, if you look at this thing, it looks heavy, but it feels so lightweight. I mean, Apple has done such a good job making this thing so lightweight.
It's perfect for Maria, for example, making it extremely durable and extremely rugged for extreme conditions. Now, is the Apple Watch Ultra big? Well, define big. What is big? For an Apple Watch, yes, of course, this is the biggest Apple Watch yet. But for a sports watch, for a dive watch, I mean, this thing is so incredibly compact.
Now, the titanium surrounds the top of the watch to protect the sapphire front glass. It actually has the biggest, now brightest display to ever come to an Apple Watch, making it twice as bright as the Apple Watch Series 8, coming at 2000 nits. It's honestly absurd how bright it can actually get in really sunny conditions, making it perfect for reading stats for the runners. Apple Watch Ultra now features a new physical button, the action button. It's customizable. For me, I have it turned on so I can start recording a video on my wrist cam. It's the most useful thing ever. Nina told me that this was one of those features that the Apple Watch simply lacked. She told me that for athletes, this is a must. I mean, you can now enable the precision start feature so you don't have to wait for that 3, 2, 1 for the workout to actually begin. You simply press and go. The microphone has also been incredibly improved.
So yes, the Apple Watch Ultra now has 3 microphones, which should improve sound quality a lot. What you are hearing right now is the microphone of the Apple Watch Ultra, and there's actually quite a lot of wind in this hike. So how do I sound? I mean, I tested it out and that sounds pretty good. Okay, back to the review. I'm falling.
The speakers are also 40% louder than the Series 8, which makes it even more useful to answer a phone call from your watch in any situation, even if you're in the middle of a hike or even if you're in a busy city. Since the speakers are so much louder, Apple has adopted the Siren.
Okay, so the Apple Watch Ultra now has a new feature called the Siren. If you're in the middle of a hike like me right now and you need help and you're alone, you can activate the siren, and Apple tells us that you can listen to the siren from up to 100 meters. So let's go ahead and test it. This is the sound right here. So I'm gonna keep going until you hear it. All right, so you guys get the point. It is extremely, extremely loud. I don't think I went 100 meters, but man, did I go up and up and up, and you guys could still hear it, which is pretty impressive. Okay, back to the review.
Now, after researching, interviewing, and talking to a bunch of triathletes, runners, hikers, the main complaint that those people had with the Apple Watch and why they always went to Garmin and a bunch of other brands was mainly because of the battery life. Just think about the fact that a triathlete, maybe let's say somebody's going on a two-day adventure and they wanted to track all of their stats, that wasn't possible previously with an Apple Watch. And that's why pro athletes didn't really take the Apple Watch seriously. But with Apple Watch Ultra, you'll get 76% larger battery life than on the Series 8, coming at 36 hours of normal use and 60 hours of battery life with low power mode. I've tested it, and yes, the battery life on the Apple Watch is absolutely insane. It lasts a long, long time. Now, here's the thing. For an Apple Watch battery, it's absolutely insane how much it lasts. But for a sports watch, it's really not that impressive. More onto that later. Something to note is that all Apple Watch Ultras have cellular, so you can go free from the phone. You can go running without your phone and still be connected with all your phone calls, text messages, and notifications. I mean, and even if you put a wrist cam on, you've got a camera to take photos. So now you truly have a free from the phone experience. Go running, go hiking without your phone, go take photos, go on video calls, go get all of your notifications. I mean, that duo is honestly impressive. Apple Watch Ultra has also been designed, you hear that? It's been designed for all extreme water and ocean sports. It is water resistant up to 100 meters and it's certified EN13319, which is basically the international standard for a dive computer. I mean, it's crazy to think about. I mean, look at this. This is a standard dive computer. It's bulky and let's be real, it's not aesthetically pleasing. I mean, it's pretty ugly. With the new depth app on Apple Watch Ultra, you'll have a super legible UI for snorkeling. It's pretty awesome the way it works. Once you're underwater, it will automatically open and it will display the time, the current depth, water temperature, the duration that you've been underwater, as well as the maximum depth you've reached on a colorful waveform background. It's awesome. Now, this isn't enough for the pro divers. I mean, let's just Maria tell you about it.
With my experience, I think that the Apple Watch Ultra gives you the basic stats like depth, dive time, and water temperature. But I'm so excited about the Dive Oceanic app, which is coming this year. And I think that I will have all that I need for a perfect dive. In the end of the day, this is only a dive watch. I'm not wearing this in a fancy dinner. And this is a diving watch and also an Apple Watch. So I can have everything here, notifications, phone calls, activity tracking. So I have everything I need in one device.
I honestly can't agree more with what Maria just said. I mean, the Apple Watch totally changed my life. It decluttered my life and makes me use my iPhone less and enjoy the beauty of the world. As romantic as that sounds, it's totally true. Getting all of my notifications right on my wrist, having emergency calling, an ECG, sleep tracking, the new compass app with backtracking, being able to capture photo and video and even video calls right on your wrist, the activity rings, the Apple Watch doesn't only motivate me to exercise but to move more. AirPods and Apple Watch, the best duo. Going running without your phone and listening to music wirelessly is unbelievable. Being able to pay for things with Apple Pay right from your wrist, Siri, maps direction, car crash detection, heart rate notification, so much. The Apple Watch does so much. Our conclusion with what the Apple Watch Ultra lacked was mainly concluded in three things. One, there is no offline maps. Number two, why is there no smaller Apple Watch Ultra? I mean, if you look at the way that Apple Watch Ultra looks on Chenya, trust me, you don't want to see it. It looks so big. And here's problem number three. Well, problem. The battery life. As I was saying, the battery life is the most impressive battery life, I'd say, in any Apple product that Apple has ever made. And that's a big statement. But the Apple Watch Ultra is targeted for runners. And every single time I interviewed and I talked and researched more about sport watches, The Apple Watch Ultra's battery, for those type of people, isn't really that impressive. I mean, there's explorers that goes days and days without any battery life. And sure, the low power mode is great. I'm just gonna say one last thing. The Apple Watch Ultra is for athletes. Yes. It's for explorers. Yes. It's for travelers. Yes. But guess what? It's for people that love the Apple Watch as much as I do and want the best display, the best ruggedness, and the best battery life. The Apple Watch Ultra isn't only a must-buy if you can justify the price, but it's honestly one of the best, if not the best, Apple product that Apple has made in years. The Apple Watch since its launch has motivated me to live a healthier life. And with the Apple Watch Ultra, it's motivating me to explore the beautiful world we live in. Because yeah, the world is meant to be explored. Because guess what? We only have one life. So I mean, let's take care of that. Be happy. Life is good. Peace.
No one wants to die. Even people who want to go to heaven don't want to die to get there. It clears out the old to make way for the new. Right now, the new is you. But someday, not too long from now, you will gradually become the old and be cleared away. Sorry to be so dramatic, but it's quite true. Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living with the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become. Everything else is secondary.